I'm here to do the next race of the 1965 F1 season. This is another non-championship points race, keeping with the trend here, and it's the Syracuse Grand Prix, which is the fourth Syracuse Grand Prix, which is at this track, Syracuse Circuit in Syracuse, Sicily, so southern Italy. It's an interesting track. You know, it's not my favorite, not one I really enjoy too much. See here, it's a small grid. A new mod came out for the 1965 mod, which gives you realistic grids and paint schemes on each track. This one was a non-championship race, so there's less cars at it. In real life, Jim Clark won, and we see him there in the 18 cars starting on the pole. So, you know, it might be the same. John Surtees in real life finished second. And there he is, lined up second on the grid, and in third place was Lorenzo Bandini, and he's sitting third, or fourth on our grid. I actually qualified third for once, so I have a good starting spot. We'll see, you know, what this race holds in store for us. I don't really know this track well. I've never actually done a full race here, and so why don't we take a look at the track. It's a pretty simple track. It's a street track, and it kind of reminds me of today's street tracks, being that they're really narrow, just walls on both sides, kind of like concrete canyons with hairpins. Now, the one thing that's missing is back in the 60s, chicanes were kind of a new thing. Chicanes to slow cars down weren't something that was done often. So that's, you know, you'll see it's missing from this track. There's no chicanes. So there's a few corners that you're very quick, and if you take them just slightly wrong, you'll whack the wall. And in real life, they'd definitely put a chicane on a few of the straightaways to slow the cars down. Like I said, you know, it's kind of a new track to me. I'm not really a fan of it. The last corner is kind of neat. It's got some cool camber. But other than that, it's just kind of a go as fast as you can, miss the walls, and then brake really hard for the chicane. So it's all about braking points. We'll be doing a 9-lap race over this track, and in real life I believe it was 56 laps, so, you know, obviously shorter. We'll take a look at the starting grid real quick. So Jim Clark, like I said, on the pole, John Surtees next to him. I qualified third, not even, you know, just a few tenths off of Jim Clark, and only a few hundredths off of Surtees. So who knows, maybe this will be the big day if I can keep it clean, get the first win, even in the non-championship race. And like a couple of the tracks before, it's a traditional starting grid, or a modern starting grid, so it's just side by side, 2x2. So without further ado, check my car setup here, and we will get going. Set it just a little over with the fuel, just to make sure we're good. And here we go to begin the Syracuse Grand Prix. Alright, so here we are on the grid. Syracuse Grand Prix. I got Surtees to my right, Jim Clark in front of me. Flag is up. And we're underway. Not a bad start. I don't think there's any room for me to squeeze past Clark. I think I got Bandini coming up my right here. Oh, and he squeezes me towards the wall. There's not much room for overtaking here. I'm going to have to do it on the slow corners. See if we can get alongside of him here. He lets me in there. Looks like I got him good that time. So gain my position back, so we're still in third. Looking forward. It's so crucial here. I make sure I don't hit walls or anything. They're right there. Corners like this one here, there's no really defined braking point. The wall kind of sweeps in on the exit. You really have to pinpoint your turn in. Little jump there on the exit. This is one of the hardest braking corners here. Brake just after that wood sign on the right. Maybe even a little later. But the exit of this corner actually opens up a bit. didn't capitalize that time. Tires are still cold. Can't really get the good drift through there. And we come up here to the very last corner of the track. Probably the only good one in my opinion. Kind of a late break, but a slide. Similar to the stuff we saw at Brands Hatch. And it did so well. Down the main straightaway to complete the first of our laps here. So third after the first lap, right where I started. Got past my teammate again. Which is good. It's good stuff. Breaking just after this sign here. Sweep around this fast corner. Closed in nicely there. Ansertes leaves the inside open for me. I'm gonna keep it close to the wall, not get into him. Looks like he's coming back. I mean, he got the better acceleration out. This is that tricky fast one again I gotta watch out for. Can't give it too much through there. Don't want to hit that wall. I definitely think I have the legs here on Syracuse. Now I knew in the last race, definitely picked up some confidence with the Ferrari, getting used to it. Now it's time to show, you know, my team and everybody who really has the speed. Lock up the left front there, try to get a good exit. Maybe put it in first gear next time through. It seems like I'm struggling for RPM on the way out. You know, the danger of wrecking out at this track is very real. I don't want to curse myself, but just one tap to those walls and tire suspension is going to be all messed up. Be hard to continue on with any sort of pace, and these days you're more likely just to park the car after you get some damage than to try to struggle through it. This is another one of those sweepers. There, make sure just don't get too wide on the exit. And watch out here, I think Surtees a little slower than me through this corner. This time he blocks the inside. Looking back, it looks like Bandini is pretty far back there. Definitely got a better exit than Surtees this time. Nah, but he's still able to get on that power sooner than me. Here we come, hard braking zone. Careful not to lock up the tires. This time I'm gonna put it into first. Oh, it almost spins the car out. Locks the rear wheels. Luckily able to save that. So sometimes if you shift down too quick, the rear wheels can only keep up so much, and they'll lock up and try to swap ends on you and try to do it to me that time. So I don't know what I'm going to be able to do there to get a better exit. Maybe have to wait a little longer to shift down, or just kind of deal with it. Maybe not the best corner to try to be making moves, just hold station through it. I'm lucky to say it was a big moment. You see all the spectators on the right side there. I can only imagine that this track was an awesome spectator circuit, just because it's, you know, on public streets and the walls right next to it. In those days, they would have let people right up to the walls. You don't see any catch fencing here. Obviously a tribute to the times, but that's how it was. This time, watch out for this corner again. heartbreaking into this corner. It's a it's got the hay bales on the outside of it, and when I was learning this track, it's got it confused with the very last corner, the one coming up, which is the super slow one. It's tough learning some of these old tracks. This one's, you know, very simple, but you know, when we get to maybe the Nürburgring or Charade, they've got so many corners, and it's just, it's tough to memorize all of them. Oh, I'm right on him this time. Oh, and he blocks the outside. I'm thinking, really, the first tight corner on the circuit at the end of, you know, the front straightaway series of corners. It's probably my best, it's looking like my best spot to maybe get by Surtees here. See, I'm so close to him this time. Maybe I can stick with him and dive to the inside going into that corner. I missed my pit board that time. I'll have to check it out next time. Surtees drifting as well. Dive him up on the inside here. He leaves it open this time. And I got him. Straight on my tail, though. He knew I was coming. This is two races in a row now that I'm able to pass Surtees here. Hopefully Ferrari's taking notice. But this time, instead of for 6th or 7th position, it is for second. I'm staring at the back of Jim Clark. We'll see how successful I am here of catching up to him. Now that my tires are a little warmer, I can afford to brake a little later for this one. Down into fourth for this final corner. Get on the gas early. You can see now Surtees is very far behind. And again, I forgot to check my pit board. You know, I get caught up so much in the action, you forget. You know, I need to make sure. You know, my team doesn't want me to come in. You never know, they could write pit right now. We see smoke coming from you, and I wouldn't have even noticed. Nice, through the apex. Alright, yeah, I definitely got the speed over Jim Clark through that corner as well. A little too hot through the middle of the corner is bad coming off. Little sideways coming into here. Not too bad, though. And definitely closing in. I think I have the speed over Clark. I don't know. Will I be able to win? Not if I lock my tires like that. Now people might wonder, you know, it's a non-championship race, does it really matter if you win? Of course it does, a win's a win. That's a very modern way of thinking if you only think about points. You know, back then, winning a race, you get all the prestige, you get in the newspapers, the people know your name after you win a race, doesn't matter if it's part of the world championship or not. And of course, winning a race now will prove to me that, you know, later in the season when we're back at the world championship tracks, I can do this. I could win a race. A little sideways and a little wide coming out of there because I'm talking too much. To concentrate, buckle down if I'm going to hope to catch Jim Clark here. sure I don't go too hot through here. Now another thing, I know it's been a few races now, and we're seeing that the engine's okay, but with a track like this, and other tracks, you know, coming in the season, Monza specifically, I'm thinking about, we have a lot of, you know, flat throttle driving, fifth gear, top gear, and just constant on the gas. You have to watch out, make sure the RPMs aren't getting too high, and right before this corner, before I'm braking for it, the RPMs are getting close to, you know, the max I would want them at. I'm right on Jim Clark now. I'll check out the pit board this time. Definitely gonna do it. Shouldn't be too many laps left here. Jim Clark's a little slow braking. Definitely think I could have the speed on him. Check it. Two laps to go. P2. Got the draft on him. I'm gonna squeeze by the. There's definitely no space up here. Oh, and I got him to the inside. Is this a good spot? Oh, me touch! Into the wall! Spinning. That was definitely not good. Not good driving, missing the left rear wheel. I'll have to get out of the car now. Luckily to walk away and not end up on the roof. Hopefully Jimmy Clark's okay as well. We could see that happening. I knew it. I shouldn't have made a move there. It was not the place to try to pass for the win. And we'll rewind the footage here. Take a look at the replay, what happened. It looks like, it was not a good place to make a move. It's coming through this corner here. Corner 2, I believe. I'm right on him, thinking as he moves to the outside, I got the inside. We'll see here. I go down. I don't know if that was my fault. I was definitely, you know, 3/4 past him. I don't know if he must have seen me. He just turns down. We were about dead even. You see how violent the wrecks are. He's flipping and landing on the roof. Hopefully he's okay, obviously. Take a look one more time at this. I'm not using the onboard cameras, trying to stay with, you know, what you would have had at the time. See with him, I'm right here. And I'm diving to the inside. And before the corner. And it looks about right here. I'm on the inside of him. He would definitely have seen me. Going for the apex now. He's turning in, also going for the apex. Maybe he's thinking I might back out of it, but he turns in and we make contact. My left rear to his right front, and sends us both spinning. And, you know, I would have to say, you know, Jim, I had that spot, but you know, even if you cause an accident, or you're part of an accident, but you didn't cause it, there's always something you could have done differently, and I should have just waited 2 more corners to get on the inside of him for the pass. I could definitely made the pass to win. So why don't we take a look now, you know, after that incident. So John Surtees, looks like my teammate here is going to win. Here he comes. I'm gonna watch him cross the line just to get the victory. Let me switch the TV one here. So he's on the final lap now. He would have seen this accident. He would have been shaken up. And after you see, especially your teammate crash, you know, a car on the side of the track burning, those thoughts are going through your head as well. Could this happen to me? But here he comes, coming up to the final corner in the track. He's got no pressure for him now. Around the last bend. Down the front straightaway to win the Syracuse Grand Prix. It could have been my victory. It could have been my Ferrari going across the line. And I'm lucky now that I'm not in hospital, you know. Tough race. But you know, at least the Ferrari still won, still on the team. And Bandini, he goes, finishes second. So Ferrari 1-2. Still angry. Mike Spence finishes third in the Lotus. Then I'm all the way down there in 10th after the accident with Jim Clark, you know, highlighted in red. Not a good event for me. But anyway, so next time we will be at Goodwood for the Sunday Mirror Trophy. And after that we go to Silverstone for the BRDC Trophy. And then we start back up with the championship at Monaco. So I thank you guys for watching this time. I hope it was enjoyable for you. If you liked the video, you know, like it, comment, subscribe. Let me know things I can improve on. And I will see you guys next time.